Good old Rodney Hollis. Let us know how you get on. Are we all invited to the wedding? And crumbs, all the people who have written about Blake Seven from... What? What is this? He says, looking astounded. What are you doing, Maggie?
Cake Seven.
No, Blake Seven, not Cake Seven.
So keen, such an enthusiast. I'll get my own back for that. John Ainsworth, one of many, many people. Well, he's in Bolton in Lancashire, but one of many, oh, dozens and dozens of people who wanted to have a couple of the people from Blake Seven on the programme. We have a couple of the stars in just a second, but here's to get you in the mood, a sort of a journey. The music and, well, sort of action from Blake Seven. What are you laughing at?
Sort of action, yes.
Well, Jacqueline and Gareth, welcome. A very good morning to you. What would you normally be doing on a Saturday?
Sleeping.
Sleeping?
Yes.
Not rushing round the universe?
No, either that or watching Swap Shop with my two children.
Oh, you brought along this morning.
Yes.
Well, it's great to see them. Thanks for coming. And are you great science fiction fans?
No. I'd never read any science fiction before the script. But I've started reading some since.
What about you, Jackie?
I haven't read any science fiction before. I haven't read any since, and I don't think I'm any clearer now I'm doing it.
Well, I got hold of sort of a, I suppose, a form of synopsis yesterday. It described each episode of the first series, and it looks so strange when it's written down.
Mm-hmm.
All the...
That's the piece of paper we never get.
You never get the explanation.
We never get the explanation, no.
Oh, I like it. So how do you follow what's going on from one week to another?
We haven't.
No, there is some of it is continuous, but most of it is just a separate story each week.
Because I was going to be terribly honest and say, well, I haven't seen the programme for the last 3 weeks.
And, so,
and you haven't seen it
I've
either.
I've never seen it, actually.
So what pitch are you at the moment?
Episode 10, I think. Although we've actually now finished recording it, but the next one to go out is episode 10, I think.
How much in advance do you do the recording?
It begins to catch up. We started off in last July filming. The programme started coming out in January. And by the time we finished the last one, which was yesterday, we've got 2.5 weeks before it goes out.
Right. And at the risk of crossing over any phone questions we might get, because it's the favourite one, how long does it take to do an episode?
10 days.
10 full working days?
Ah, no. The 10 days includes 3 days in studio, a weekend. You end up actually going in, reading the script, and a couple of days later you're doing it. But theoretically it's 10 days.
I get the impression from the way you're talking that you've probably spent your whole time falling about laughing
while
you're doing it.
That actually is the best thing about it. All of us get on terribly well together, despite what you see on the screen.
So it's not a terribly serious pursuit the whole time?
Oh, no.
No, not until we actually get on the studio floor, then we take it seriously.
We do?
No, we don't.
I'm also going to be terribly honest and say, Jacqueline, I haven't seen you in other things. I've seen Gareth, but you were playing a policeman time ago.
Yeah.
You had a heavy role doing all that.
Yes.
What other sorts of things were you doing before Blake Seven?
In between the first two lots, there was a break and I did Measure for Measure.
Mm-hmm.
My mind's got a complete blank. I did Otherwise Engaged in the theatre and then again in Vienna. Isn't it wonderful? But usually I'm hidden under wigs.
Why?
Why? Gareth, why am I hidden under wigs?
Because the British public don't like a female Kojak.
No, this was before I had the female Kojak. So now people can see me on television and recognise me from the haircut before they would see me and not know who it was.
How do you feel about having the Barnet like that?
I love it.
You do?
Yeah, it's no trouble.
It wasn't a great sacrifice.
Not at all.
And you two, in fact, are throwing away the whole idea that you're enemies.
Well, I mean, we can't really fight on here, can we?
Well, it would help us. I mean, it would help us to get the atmosphere of the programme over.
Should have seen us before. No. Yes, we are theoretically enemies, but the fascinating thing is that we've confronted each other various times during the series mm-hmm. and never actually done anything about it. I mean, she's actually had a gun pointed at me and didn't fire it.
Shame, reason, really.
Well, it is, actually, yes.
Will there be any chance of that happening?
Not from Jackie, no. No.
But possibly from other quarters.
Possibly from other quarters. Or even other halves.
Very good.
Very good.
Grab a telephone, because I've had my fair share of questions. We've got someone on line four. There's a yellow one there. We're trying to colour-code them with the rest of the jungle.
Oh, there's a yellow one there.
Oh. Right, line four.
Hello, this is Thomas Conway.
Hello, Tom. Right, what's your question?
Gareth, did you find an easy programme to make?
A difficult programme to make?
No, or an easy
programme to make?
No, because there's an awful lot of special effects and explosions and things like that, and occasionally we are actually asked to be very close to an explosion, which doesn't actually make life very easy.
Is that it, Tom, or anything else you want to know?
Yes, to see the little models, were they very complex? Did you see them being made?
We didn't see them being made. No, they bring them into the studio already made. And then do all sorts of very clever things with them, with cameras and all sorts of things. But we only saw them when they were actually made. But they are very complicated, yes. And larger than you would expect, too.
Yes, because I've seen them on before.
Pardon?
I've seen them once, little models getting shown in the TV.
Yes, well, in fact, we showed some models for the series on this programme. Is that where you saw them?
Yes.
Yeah. Jolly good. Well, it's good to know that you're a fan of the programme. Thank you very much indeed for phoning us, Tom.
Okay.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Cheers.
Line five.
Hi.
Hi, who are you?
Colin Fletcher.
Hello, Colin. What's your question?
Well, can I speak to Gareth, please?
Right, certainly.
You know when you're on the Liberator?
Yes.
And you're talking to Zen and all the robots?
Yes.
Do you find it difficult? Do you feel funny talking to robots and things?
Ah, no, because as long as it talks back to you, it doesn't really matter. I mean, after all, most of us are robots anyway.
Oh.
No, it's not difficult at all.
Do you have any problems, Jacqueline, that way?
Talking to robots?
Yeah.
No, I agree with him. Most of us are anyway.
Can you see life going that way? Can you see us all having our own robot at some point?
I know a lot of people do feel that, yeah. But I would not like to think that was so at all.
Right.
I do believe, basically, in man's inherent goodness. We're going to win. Okay?
We've got to win.
Any other questions, Colin?
You know when you see Travis?
Yes.
Do you like him, or do you really treat him as evil, you know?
Well, there's a secret there. Actually, the man who plays Travis is slightly bigger than I am. So I've got to like him, because otherwise he'd thump me. That's the answer to that one, very simply.
All right, there you go. Thank you very much indeed for phoning us.
Thank you very much.
Bye-bye. Line six.
Hello?
Hi, who's this?
Peter John Noble.
Hello, Peter. Right. What's your question?
I'd like to ask Gareth if he thinks that in the future there'll ever be anything like the Federation.
I sincerely hope not, is the only answer I can give to that.
Oh.
Because if there is, then Blake 7 will come true and somebody's going to go around trying to smash it up and then you've got another war on your hands.
Oh. But you'd be in line for the job.
But I'd be in line for the job if I'm still alive.
Yeah, because you're more qualified than most. What do you think, Peter? Are you making a prophecy?
I don't think there'll ever be anything like it.
And presumably you hope there wouldn't?
No, I don't.
You don't hope there wouldn't?
There wouldn't be, or you do?
No, there wouldn't.
Yeah, I think you agree with us. Could you see yourself as a Blake? Is that sort of a swashbuckling role that you might like to live?
I don't think so.
No? All right, thank you very much for your question. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Line one.
Hello?
Hi, who are you?
Ian Fleming.
Hello, Ian, there's no need to shout. We've got a phone here.
Can I talk to Gareth Thomas, please?
Yes, he's on the phone. Right. What's your question, Ian?
When you're out and about on the street.
You said you don't have to shout. Try it at a normal voice.
Do people expect you to be as tough as you are on Blake 7?
Sometimes yes, and sometimes no. If it's yes, then I usually run, and if it's no, I'll stop and talk.
What about you, Jacqueline? Do you find that people expect you to be living a role the whole time?
Yes, I think they do. And a lot of people say I am.
There's no way out of that. Thank you for your question. Bye-bye.
It's not true, it's not
Line
true.
Two.
Hello, Robert Jones.
Hello, Robert. Right, what's your question?
Gareth, please.
Right, uh-huh. Yeah, he's on the phone.
I'm here.
How much sleep do you usually get every night whilst you're filming?
That depends on whether we're filming at night or not. It also depends on the light, because you have to stop filming when it gets dark. So we get a fair amount of sleep.
And what do you have to give up to do filming? Do you have to give up smoking and drinking late night?
No.
Oh, no. No.
No way.
No. We couldn't do that.
They're professionals, but they're not that professional.
No, what you do have to give up is an awful lot of social life, like going out to dinner and seeing people and friends, because you just don't have time to do it.
Okay, thank you. Line three.
David Dunster here.
Hello, David. What's your question?
I'd like to ask Gareth a question on, are you all friends off stage as well, two enemies? Are you friends off stage, or do you have any enemies?
I don't have any enemies. No, we're all very great friends, which is probably why we enjoy doing the whole thing so much. We get on extremely well together.
Do you mind pointing guns in their face and that and shooting them?
As long as they're not loaded, no. In fact, it's a cheat, because when there is a gun actually fired, we get out of the way, needless to say.
Okay, I'd like to ask you another question. Do you think ships like the Liberator and the Federation ships will be built in the future?
They're being built now. Not quite as swish as the Liberator, but they are building them now. I mean, there's a rocket ship now called Pioneer 10, which took off in 1972 from America. This is knowledge here. Took off in 1972 from America, went to Jupiter, was boosted by Jupiter's atmosphere, and is now going to carry on into deep space for at least 80,000 years. Did you know that?
No, I didn't.
Yes, who told you that?
I read it in the encyclopedia last night.
Gosh, I was impressed for a minute there. Thank you very much for your questions. I hope that's baffled you.
Thank you.
All stunned here with that piece of information. So when's it coming back?
It's never coming back.
Oh, it's never coming back.
It's literally going to go on ad infinitum.
Well, that's
it also contains a message by a man called Carl Sagan.
Oh, yes, I've read about it.
Yeah, who are from mankind, in case it's intercepted by any other extraterrestrial force.
Yes. Mm. Wonder what the message is.
So do I.
Help.
Help! Yes, line four. Hi, line four.
Hello?
Hi, who are you?
Paula Gregory.
Hello, Paula. Right, what's your question?
Can I speak to Jackie, please?
Right, yes, she's on the line.
Jackie, when you watch the programme on telly, do you think you could have done better in some way?
Frequently, I tell you.
Bye!
Are you very critical of your own performance?
Yes, I am. I find it very interesting to watch because there are so many things to be learned from watching. Unfortunately, you never get the chance to put right what you've done wrong on that particular show. But hopefully one can carry it over and not make the same mistake on the next one.
Okay. Thank you.
Line five.
Hello.
Hi.
It's Martin Smith.
Hello, Martin. What's your question?
I'd like to ask both of you a question. When you use long scientific words on the programme, are they real or are they just made up?
Mixture of both. You've got to be very careful using real scientific words because you're liable to have a scientist watching who will actually know what it means. But there's a mixture of both.
Can I ask you another question?
Please do.
Are the models, is there just one or are there loads of them?
What, of each ship, you mean?
Yes, of just the Liberator.
Oh, no, there are a lot of models. All the spaceships actually have to be models. I think there are two, actually, of the Liberator, because there are two different sizes.
Oh.
There's one for slightly closer shots and one for longer things and flying through space on the end of a piece of string and all that sort of thing.
Thank you.
Okay, bye. Thank you very much. I'm afraid that's all we've got time for at the moment on the phones. We had Matt Irvin on the programme, who works in the department here that does all those models, and they really are superb.
Oh, superbly made.
One of the things I'd like to ask you about the way in which you do the programme, do you ever find, because of the sort of time schedule, that you've got to...
You're having a fight with the phone and I'm...
That you have to accept maybe, not a fluffed line, but a performance that you wouldn't... You know, you'd want to go back, but they can't do that. Does that ever happen?
Yes, often. I mean, basically, as far as performance is concerned, Sir Lord Olivier, as you know, is once said, if ever he gave the perfect performance, he'd give up acting.
Yeah. Very critical of your performance? In anything?
Yes, in everything, although I never actually watch myself.
Coward?
Yes. I get terribly depressed and want to go back and do it again, and I can't.
Mm. Well, you showed us a great space knowledge there, and you brought along a kit of the space shuttle. What else have you brought along here?
Jackie?
Well, I bought Travis's eye patch.
Very good. Okay.
Typical female, scratched it out first and brought it along.
He gave it willingly.
And I brought a liberator bracelet, which with which we teleport, which has actually never been allowed off the programme, I think I'm right in saying. It's the only one there is to actually go anywhere.
Super. So a real personal one-off there.
We but need might a... I also quickly say that they can't actually use it unless the liberator is very close. But
yeah.
It needs a two-way.
Well, are there instructions with it?
No.
Oh,
no, you've got to guess. We had to.
Oh. Well, a bracelet without a training programme to go with it. What about a question, please?
The question. I'm not going to blow this right now. Okay, the question is, who composed the Planet Suite?
Right, that's clear enough. So that's postcards, please, on that. Who composed the Planet Suite? Now, we had Billy Connolly. Connolly. I did it last week. Connolly. Connolly on the programme. And he brought along some wellies. And he also took off his belt and gave us that. It was splendid. Badge on it. And also records and programmes from his Big Wee tour. Could you have a delve in there? Who's going to do this?
It should be Jackie, really, shouldn't it?
Well, I think you're strong. You ought to do the twist, and Jackie ought to have the delve.
Oh, dear, here we go. Oh,
you really are entering into the spirit of this.
I think you could turn it here.
I'll turn it
what,
there, yeah.
What he wanted to know was, why do we say bless you when somebody sneezes? Do you know that?
Yes.
You do? Well, tell us. Please do.
Oh, because I believe it goes back to the plague.
Yes.
And it's the same thing as ring a ring a roses, a tissue, a tissue, we all fall down.
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly, yes. The marks left by the disease.
The disease, yeah.
The ring a ring of roses and tissue, tissue, and unfortunately people died.
Sneeze and bless you.
Right.
Yes, that's quite right. So who was it? Who gets the goodies?
Jean Hannah, 186 Barclay Street, Glasgow, C3.
Oh, that's great. That's good for Billy Connolly to get a glass of each, and that's good.
Yes,
well, it wasn't fixed. Can I hold on to that so that we don't lose it? Jolly good. Congratulations to Jean Hannah. And thank you, Jacqueline. And thank you, Gareth, very much indeed for coming along. I wish you many happy journeys in space.
Thank you.
And when's another series of the programmes coming out?
I think we start filming again in...
July.
The end of July.
She knows everything. She keeps you going.
That's right.
Okay, well, we get a chance now to have a look at a clip from a forthcoming edition of Blake 7. Thanks again.
Thank you.